Hello, dear students, it gives me great pleasure to talk to you on this occasion of Educational Week of Students Association of Medical Technologists. Hope you all are fine and doing well, although in lockdown in present COVID-19 crisis. I congratulate all of you for not only for fighting out this crisis, but also for making use of adverse situations to raise your several educational abilities like reading, thinking, innovating, spending minimum time on mobiles, and improving various soft skill abilities. You must also have realized that how important is our MLT field, which is in most demand all over the world in helping the world population not only to diagnose the disease but also to work on diagnostic kits, medicines and vaccines. Well, we are succeeding in getting rid of COVID-2019 crisis soon, and then question obviously will come to your mind is what will happen to MLT and DMLT community post Corona-19 phase. And yes, that was the first question from you. And I must tell you that all the questions asked by you were excellent, very good, and show very good quality of your educational systems. Well, so the answer for the first question is like this. MLT field will be in most demand all over the world to work on diagnostic kits, medicines and vaccines now at faster rate. We cannot wait for a year if another virus breaks havoc in future. You will get large number of opportunities in diagnostic technology, pharmaceutical companies, in clinical trial companies, research industry and educational field, apart from hospital and private laboratories, which also will increase in large number. Next question is question 2. What are the additional topics needed to improve present MLT syllabus? And the answer is, your theory syllabi are very well made. Just check if they contain these topics: emerging and re-emerging infections, WHO and sub-national recommended immunization programs, diseases of immunocompromised persons, vaccines, national vaccine-borne disease control programs, etiology and pathogenesis of surgical infections, drug-resistance pathogens, obstructive airway diseases, cancer markers, immunotherapy and gene therapy. Yes, very important. In practicals, PCR, RT-PCR, flow cytometry, dot blot techniques, cytogenetic techniques, DNA sequencing, microarray dot blot techniques must be taught hands-on in practicals or by observation, and see if life support skills are included in your syllabus, and also practicals of plotting of LJ, Lebesgue charts, and Westergaard rules. All this information is there in all our books. Question 3 is explanation on advanced virology techniques and use in laboratory medicine. Answer: for that, immediately watch my two following videos from our educational channel on YouTube. I will send this to your organization, and that is screening test for COVID-19, PCR and COVID-19 RT-PCR test. And also refer to our medical microbiology book, chapter 11, 12, 16 and appendix pages, or MLT book chapters 35, 36, 42, 43 and 44. Next question, question number 4 is, in the age of artificial intelligence, robotics and automation, what are the job prospects for MLT? Don't get worried, really. Day by day, there will be more and more automated instruments will come. But then again, there are plenty of opportunities now will be available in total quality management field. Learn total quality management very well. Refer to our MLT book, chapter 6, and watch our related videos on YouTube, particularly on career opportunities. And plenty of jobs will be available, as I said earlier, in large number in laboratories dealing with research, clinical trials, and diagnostic technology. Next question is question 5. How will metabolones help in disruption of cancer? Well, a metabolome is a temporary structural functional complex formed between sequential enzymes of a metabolic pathway, held together both by non-covalent interactions and by structural elements of the cell. And tumors proliferate in acidic conditions, that means they grow very fast in acidic conditions, managed by their own acid-base metabolomes. So drugs can be synthesized which can modulate highly acidic conditions related cancer cell metabolomes to alkaline conditions and decrease their proliferation of cancer cells, leading to their destruction. Next question is question 6. How to distinguish between animal blood and human blood in a laboratory? And the answer is very simple, by using Raman spectroscopy. Raman spectrometer includes three main components, such as laser beam, the sampling interface, and the spectrometer itself. See, I have placed this particular slide, and from this slide you will see the various spectra, and that will answer your question very well. Another way to distinguish between animal blood and human blood is by testing their DNA setup, because DNA setup of every animal species is different. So by DNA sequencing or dot blot technique, it is possible to find out the difference between human blood and animal blood. Refer page 1374, chapter 43 in our MLT book, 3rd edition. And for dot blot microarray techniques, experiment 43.1 for separation of DNA from white blood cells. Well, I take this opportunity to thank Professor Nitin and President of SAMT, Mr. Nawaz Sharif, and all the teachers and students for their great educational contribution in MLT, and also for giving me opportunity to communicate with you all. Hope we all will come out of this critical Corona-19 phase very soon, and future will open doors for all our dear students towards wonderful success. So thank you once again. Take care and have a wonderful educational week and a great year ahead. All the best.